Hey boys and girls, Mike here. One go short play, as if you had to ask. And today we are quietly playing, because sleeping, Airball for the NES. Ooh, this is cooler than I thought it would look. So you're a dude who's been turned into a blob, a ball, if you will. A ball of air, if you will. It's got shades of head over heels and Batman for the Spectrum. Remember, Spectrum on here. And it's got especially shades of those games because it looks like it really falls victim to the three colours per 8x8 square attribute thing. The Spectrum had a similar limitation. It was two colours per 8x8 square, which really limited things. I'm not sure, is the NES three colours or is it four? Someone who knows, tell me, because I'm a real nerd for that stuff. I'm that person who on the Spectrum groups was posting pictures of Spectrum games reimagined as I'd like them to look, or would have liked them to look as a kid, because let's face it, who's going to help me make them now? Training easy, hard. Well, pardon me, hiccups. The defaults to training. Was it a hiccup or a burp? It was somewhere between the two, who knows? But I don't want to train. I want to. Should we just hardcore it? Let's do it. Get the spellbook. Oh, it's sampling this roughly to the quality of the Mega Drive, which is actually quite good. Okay, looks like I can slide. Oh, just don't slide off the track. I need to turn my pad on that angle to play this game. So I'm just gonna. Oh, we don't want to do that. We don't want to do that. We basically don't want to touch things that'll kill us. I thought you could bounce, or you can bounce. That's not very clear, is it? Look at that. What's going on there? Need a torch. It's alright, I've got the hang of it. Wow, it's amazing what they've done with two colours, to be honest. That's two colours. I mean, that's what the Spectrum looked like most of the time, to be fair to it. Are they spikes? They look like spikes. I don't trust it. I'm going this way. I don't know why I've chosen down. It was just going that way. Literally. Are we going right now? Screen right. What the heck? Fire! Oh, really? Okay, now I'm going to try that again. We're going downwards. Get the spellbook. That is what I've got to say. I've got a feeling that is the whole game's mission. I've got a feeling that isn't just like a submission that, you know, for this level now that I've got to do. That's weird. In fact, I'm having trouble with this bit. There we go. Maybe it's up there. Can I go up there? Yes, I can. What about... Oh, no! Okay, that's interesting. Why does it allow you that far up? No reason. Right, that is definitely spikes over there. Maybe just to demonstrate that you can use blocks to climb. I want to beat that room that beat me just then. That was this room. And here, right in the middle, there are invisible deaths. There are invisible deaths. Ah, it's better. We can actually see. Suddenly the game became easier because we can see. The trouble is... If I die now, I'll go right back to the beginning. This way. And that looks like a hand pointing up. All I can do is jump. And then pull things and out. Push things and out. It's kind of easier to play than head over heels, actually. I don't know why. I think it's faster. And you can kind of... Yeah, you can do diagonals. Although it feels a bit Atari 2600, the way it moves about. There's no way out of this room except up, but I'm not sure how to get up. Can I double jump? I'm getting a bit, I'm getting high hopes, aren't I, for a game of this age. I can't do that. I could select, I could... Ah, no! Do you know what? Pause. That was annoying. I hit that. Takes me straight to the Steam bootstrapper. Like, it's like Steam owns this laptop. I'm just determined to let me know it. It's because my camera broke. Well, my camera stopped working, so I rebooted my laptop, which is something I very rarely do and don't do anywhere near enough these days, to be honest. I've given up on that route, by the way. Oh, I died. So I pressed that button. No, so I reset the laptop, and of course Steam auto started. And now when I hit that button, Steam bootstrap. Yeah, go on again, I've got one more chance. Yeah, I think that's a bit of a liberty, but hey. See, that finger is saying something. Or is it just a random thing, because there's two fingers pointing down over there. Let's just go this way now, find out what's what. At least you can see. At least I can see stuff. What's that over there? It's probably death. Oh no, give me points. Oh, that's half the trouble with this game. Figuring out what is points and what is death. That's death. Who'd have known? Oh, again. Going right. Oh, I got points there as well. I don't know what for though. I didn't really see it. Okay, so diamonds are points. And those random rhomboid shapes. Rhomboid, I don't know what it was. Some kind of weird square. Putting the pad on an angle again. I figure out where I'm going. Probably like symmetric games and a square pad. That use the square pad. Even though this can use diagonals. But let's face it, diagonals are tricky if the whole game is built around them. It was worth it just for that. Oh no, get off me! Okay, we're going up. I saw enough of that direction. Alright, we have to jump up the steps. Come on, Mikey, you know this. It's alright, it's a good game. If you're into that. If you like Head Over Heels, I'm sure you'd love this. It's like Head Over Heels, but faster than that. Is it death? Probably. Yeah, it's like super fast Head Over Heels without much animation to it. As I say, oh. yeah, it's alright, not my cup of tea at all though. I was one of the kids on the spectrum that really, really didn't like Head Over Heels. Just thought it was slow and dull and wasn't for me. That was okay, it was better, I think, because it was faster. Yeah, that's about it. That was a prototype, apparently, of a game called Airball for the NES. Don't know if it ever came out, but all the more reason for you to go and seek it out if you're into NES stuff. Thanks for watching.